I am deeply remorseful for my actions on Tuesday night. I behaved in a manner I am not proud of. I've been dealing with some personal challenges over the past several months, but that is no excuse for how I acted. The importance of mental and emotional health is extremely real, and I vow to get help that I need. I appreciate all of the people who have reached out in support of me and my family, including the community here in Seattle. I am very grateful to have such an amazing wife, family, and support system to lean on during this time.
You know me, SDMT. Let's get it, baby. But before we do, make sure hit that like, subscribe, and turn on notifications, man. Join the gang. SDMT coming with that fire, the hottest topics in sports daily, man. Let's get to it, man. You guys got to see Richard Sherman's statement. You know what I mean? He's very apologetic, and he's very thankful for the people that are supporting him through this tough time. He's definitely going through some mental health issues he's talking about and some just overall troubles. I posted the video of him attacking the door on my Instagram. A lot of people got offended by that. But sometimes we need to see where people are at for us to truly believe it. You know what I mean? For me, I didn't know it was that bad till I seen him. And I'm like, oh man, he's tweaking. You know what I mean? Sums up Richard Sherman. You know what I mean? We have a lot of people trying to cover these things up. Oh, it's everybody else. It's his wife. And they're slandering his wife and all this stuff. And it's just like, you guys are the problem. You know what I mean? You can't fix the problem if you guys start trying to deflect to other things, trying to blame other people to cover up that this person may need some help. Richard Sherman said it himself. He's going to look to get help. So a lot of NFL players have had CTE issues. They've had players problems giving up football and transitioning to normal life. A lot of guys go through depressions. A lot of guys have killed themselves and hurt other people. So Richard Sherman is going through his own battles right now, and he needs support. He doesn't need people, you know what I mean, trying to cover up for him and blame other people. You know what I mean? I decided to take the video down just because enough people had seen it, and I didn't want it up there any longer, especially after he made his statement. You know what I mean? And you get to see where he's at. You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, it's great to hear that he's out of jail. He is looking at 5 charges, which it doesn't mean much right now. They like the DAs throw charges, but you go to court, and the court, the judge takes a lot of the charges down. And we already know Richard Sherman's gonna have a great lawyer, so I doubt anything comes from that. If he says, I doubt he serves any jail time, but he's looking at the domestic violence, which he didn't assault anyone, but because of his relationship with his, father-in-law's home, that they knew each other, they're calling that domestic violence. Him, you know, coming to their house, you know, beating on the door, I guess. Also, he had a DUI, resisting arrest, malicious mischief with the domestic violence. And that's pretty much the charges he's looking at. But more importantly, man, it's great that he put that, statement out there. There were a lot of reports. I was investigating that he's been having personal issues, and a lot of former teammates and friends have been coming out to help him. I looked at his Instagram. He was out hanging out with some of the former players, and he kind of didn't look right in the photo. When you look at him, looks like he's like going through some stuff. You know what I mean? So he hasn't been picked up. You know what I mean? That could be weighing on him. Is his NFL career over? Is anybody going to give him a chance? Now with this issue, it's likely he's not going to get opportunity because off the field, and teams want to make sure he has right mental health going on. But you know what I mean, when you give up on football, man, when you have to walk away from football, it's different for everybody. I went through a depression. I didn't even watch football for a year of my life. And if you know me, how much I love football, you know what I mean, that's crazy. And you know what I mean, so Richard Sherman's going through a transition, whether he's going to have to accept that he's going to have to retire soon, or you know, if he's having CTE issues or any other issues. But at the end of the day, it's hard for a lot of times for guys to move on, to give away that identity of a football player, as an NFL player. You grow up, you're part of this program and this system your whole life, going to football practice, going to meetings, doing these things, being a star in games, being newspapers, being on TV, and that's taken away from you, and you gotta be a normal gym, a normal guy. You're not normal, but you are normal because you're not being praised on Sundays or Saturdays or, you know, during football talk. So you kind of fade away. So that's definitely can challenge your mental health, because it's a major transition in your life. When you go through a lot of major transitions in your life, it's hard, and you got to adapt. We look at somebody like Richard Sherman. He's definitely at the twilight of his career. Is that a factor in him, you know, acting in this way? I believe so. I believe it's a part of it, because he's definitely not on the team. If he was on a team, would this happen? I don't believe so. You know what I mean? And the fact that the DUI, he left the scene, that could have been him trying to, you know, not have that on his record, not get caught for that because he wanted to be on a team. So, you know, this is a crazy situation, man. I wish and pray the best for Richard Sherman, man. You know what I mean? He's been great for the, you know, the community and the culture. He's very intelligent. You know what I mean? It's just that we all go through things. You know what I mean? And a lot of times, instead of hating on somebody, putting them down, or trying to cover up and blame people around them, we just need to identify that they need help and hopefully help point them in the right direction. All right? Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on my notifications. And that's a wrap on SDMT!